Hello Techie, welcome back to my YouTube channel Tech Solution. I want to teach you the Python as the faster way as possible and more practical way. Now before we get started, please subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification by clicking on the bell icon. Okay, if you watch my last video, I'm trying to cover tuple. Okay, today I'm trying to cover what is set and all the operation that behind the set and method. Okay, let's see what we are going to capture or cover in set operation. First we are going to define what is set, then we are going to define what is access item, how we are going to access the items in a set, and then we are going to define change items. If we are going to set one time, then how we are going to change it. Then I will go with add items. How can we add one or more item? After that, get the length of a set. Then how we are going to remove items. Then join two sets. Then set constructor. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I will try to cover all the 8 items in the set. Okay, let's start with set. How we are going to define the set? Okay, basically set is a collection which is unordered and unindexed. In Python, sets are written with curly brackets. Okay, let's see how we are going to write set. This set equal to in the curly braces, same example, apple, banana, cherry. Okay, now if you're going to print type of this set, okay, and again this set spelling mistake, print type, because this set is not defined, that means the variable that you are trying to access that is not available. Okay, class set, that means this variable we define it, that is set. Okay, the good thing about sets are unordered, so you cannot be sure in which order the item will appear. Okay, what does mean? Let's start with access items. Okay, you cannot access items in a set by referring to an index or a key, but you can loop through the set items using a for loop or ask if a specified value is present in a set by using the key in keywords. Okay, what does mean? Let this set equal to tech solutions python Techie. Okay, now print of type of this set, this is set. Now I'm going to loop it for x in this set, print x. Okay, we can loop it. Techie, Python and Tech Solution, right? See, I said it, this is might be that is not the way we can do, but if you see, this is unordered, right? In the first is the Tech Solution, second one is the Python, and third one is Techie. But if you are going to loop, that is this set with x and then print x, let's see what's Techie, Python and Tech Solution. Okay, but if you are going to use same functions and same for loop and runs again, might be you will not get the the same output. The order might be different. Okay, that's we can say the one of the disadvantage in the set, because we are not going to predict, okay, what is the order that is going to print when you are going to use print keywords. Okay, that's one of the disadvantage I can say. Okay, now we'll go with if banana is present or not. Say for example print using the in keyword. Just like a Python in this set. Okay, true. That means Python is present in this set, right? Now go with another example, print apple in this set, and it will return false. Okay, why? This set the apple is not present, that's why it's written false. Okay, now it's clear. Now we are going to change items. Once a set is created, you cannot change this item, but you can add new items. Okay, how we are going to add the new items? To add a new items to a set, we have to use add methods. And if you want to add more than one item to a set, use the update method. Add method for adding one item in a set. Okay, update method for adding multiple item in a set. Okay, it's clear. Now we'll go with example. This set apple, banana, cherry. This set, if you like orange, then add orange. Okay, and then print of this set. This set banana, apple and cherry. This set, see, this is the set, the spelling is again stick here. This set double S, add orange and print this set. Okay, now you see it here, banana, cherry, orange and apple. We are adding orange right here. But you see apple, banana and cherry. If you watch my last video that I explained about list and tuple, then add is always going to last items, right? But as I said, the set is basically is when you are going to add any item, we don't know what will be order, right? That's why if you are going to add orange into that, then you say banana, cherry and orange and then apple, right? In orange, add in third items. You can say second index 0, 1, 2. Okay. Now it's clear. Now I'm going to add multiple items to a set using the update method. This set dot update mango, cherry, all these gaps. Okay, these two items I'm going to update it. Enter. Now if you're going to print this set, what it will print? It will print, because already add orange, then apple, banana, cherry, orange, mango and grapes. Okay, right, 1 2 3 4 5 6, right? And you see it is, again it's not an order, right? It's an order, right? Is it clear? Now we'll check what's the length of this set. To determine how many items a set has, then we have to use the length method. Same, if you remember, length keyword we are used in the tuple also and in the list also. Same in the set also we are going to use. Now if you are going to print length this set, okay, what it will print? 6, right? 1 2 3 4 5 6, enter, correct. Now we'll go with another example. This length equal to, let's like a tech solution Python, right? 3 should print, right? Length of this LEN, okay, 3, is it okay? Now we are going to say how we are going to remove an item. To remove an item in a set, we have to use two method. Either we can go with remove, either we go with discard method. Remove, we are going to use two method. First is the remove itself and second is the discard. Okay, I will tell you what the difference between both of them. Okay, let's go with this remove equal to apple, cherry and banana. Okay, this remove dot remove then banana. Okay, now is remove. Now print of this REM, then what will happen? Banana is going to remove. Okay, we are going to print only cherry and apple, right? You can see apple and cherry first, and we're going to print is cherry and apple, is an order, right? Now we'll go with one more example. Okay, what will happen if you are going to remove something and then doesn't exit into the set? What it will be do? Let's see. If I try to remove, print this REM dot remove. If I am going to remove again banana, what do you think? What will be the output? It will give error. Okay. Okay, we print is not defined. This is a different error. Print, do copy and paste. Print. Okay, what is saying? Banana, key error banana. Why? Because banana is not exit into the list in the set. In the set, basically we have only cherry and apple, right? And we are trying to remove banana that doesn't exit into the set, right? Correct. That's why it's giving error. Okay, now I will show the same example with discard. Okay, this discard, we're going to set apple, banana and cherry. Okay, and now we are going to this dot discard banana. Okay, now print this discard. Okay, what it will print? It will print the same apple and cherry. Okay, correct. Now see what's the difference. Now if you are going to remove this discard dot discard and then the banana, then doesn't exit here. In the remove, what will happen is giving the error. But the difference between discard and remove, discard will not give an error. Okay, see, even this banana doesn't exit into the set. Now if you are going to print this, see, cherry and banana, apple is there, right? This banana is not present, but discard will not give error. Then what the difference? If the item, when we are using remove and if items doesn't exit, then it will give error. But discard will not give error. Okay, that is clear now the difference. When you want to, it's like in the real time example, when you want to suppress, but I will not suggest, then you have to use discard, because when you have any atom is not exit, then it will not give error. But remove, when you are going to in the client side, when you have something goes wrong, then the client notified, okay, this because of this reason the item doesn't exit, it will easy to know, right? Now we'll go with another example, pop. You can also use pop method to remove an items, but this method will remove the last item. Remember, the sets are unordered, so you will not know what items that gets removed. The return value of the pop method is the remove items. Okay, I will show with the example pop method. This pop apples in banana and cherry. Okay, and when if you're going to x is equal to this pop dot pop, okay, and if you're going to print x, what will happen? Banana, right? It will print. See, this is unordered. Ideally, if you're going to use in the list or tuple, then it will print the cherry, right, the last item, but because this is unordered, then we don't know what the item will be returned. Okay, that's, if you're going to returns, okay, let's see what the this pop values, print of this pop, okay, cherry and apple. Now if you're going to again print this pop dot pop, see, either it will return cherry also, either it will return apple also, we don't know. Now it's written cherry also, right? It's unpredictable basically what it will return, because this is an order. Now, because sets are an order, so when using the pop method, you will not know which item that gets removed. Okay. Now go with another example, clear methods. Clear method basically that empty the sets. That empties the set. Okay. This CLR equal to apple cherry banana. Okay. Now if this CLR dot clear and print, okay, what will return? None. Okay, that means the list is empty. Now if you are going to print this CLR it will empty set. Okay, sets is empty, nothing is there, right? Is it clear now? Now go with one more example, this CLR1 same apple and cherry, and this CLR1 dot clear, and we're going to print this CLR1, it will return same empty set. Okay, now we'll go with another example, del method. Okay, del method basically is to delete the set completely. Okay, means if the any variable that hold the memory, and if you are going to use del method, it will clear the memory also. Okay, it doesn't exit. Okay, del methods, if you are using this dot del equal to apple take, I will mix it this time, solutions, Python. Okay, now if you are going to print, go first remove it, this del equal to dot del method. Okay, this del. Okay, now enter, because I using del, but del before that the variable that is using. Okay, now if you are going to print this del, okay, because del doesn't exist, it will give an error. Okay, what will happen? This del is not defined. It's same like the variable doesn't exist. Alright, that's why it's giving error. We'll go with one more example. Take del equal to take solutions Python. Okay, and if I'm going to del, take del, now print take del, it will give take del is not, because you already removed the memory where the take del exists, right? That is clear. Now I'm going to show how we are going to join two sets. There are several ways to join two or more sets in Python. Either you can use the union method that returns a new set containing all the items from both the sets, or the update methods that will insert all the items from one set into another sets. Okay, first we'll go with join two sets. Okay, first methods I'm going to show you union. Okay, another method we have update. Okay, these two methods we can join the two sets. Let's go one by one. Set 1 equal to 1, 2, 3, and set 2 equal to A, B, and C. Okay, now set 3 equal to set 1 dot union set 2. Okay, now if I want to print set 3, then it will be add the both of them. Okay, 1, 2, 3, see here 1, 2, 3 is the right order, but ABC is not in order, CBA, right? Now we'll go with another example, update matters same, insert the item into set 2 into set 1, just like that. Same example, I will go with that set 1 dot update set 2. Okay, now if I'm going to print set 1, it will contain 1, 2, 3 and ABC. Okay, 1, 2, 3 CBA, right? Because set 1 is going to update with set 2. Okay, here what I'm trying to do, set 3 is basically the third set, that is combination of, that is union of set 1 and set 2. Okay, here what I'm trying to do, set 1 only. Set 1 is already updated with 1, 2, 3 CBA. Okay, now it's clear now. Now both union update will exclude and duplicate items. Okay, if there are other methods that join the two set that keep only the duplicate and never the duplicate, check the full set, full list of set method in the bottom of this page. I will show you. See, if you are going to print set 1 dot union of set 2. Okay, what is set 1? 1, 2, 3 CBA. And what is set 2? ABC. If I'm going to enter, see what it will be, 1, 2, 3 ACB. What does it mean? If I'm going to use union or update, it will remove the duplicate items. Okay, that is clear now. Now go with set constructor. set equal to, we have to use set keywords. Okay, apple, banana and cherry. Okay, note that here the double bracket is there, right? Parenthesis, this two parentheses and those two parentheses, and we have to use set keyword to convert this way, this values or this list to the set. Okay, now if I am going to print this set, it will come as a curly braces. Okay, banana, cherry and apple. Okay, if I am going to use to verify, once again use type of this set. Okay, this is a set, right? Class is set. Okay, now it's clear now. Okay, for today lecture that's it. Now if you enjoy this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit the subscribe button before you go. Okay, thank you so much for watching my video. So if you want my watch video in future, just subscribe below bell icon. He will notify you when my new video will come. And please don't forget to like and share. Thank you.